What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. Now, y'all, I just watched the National Association of Black Journalists embarrass themselves. I almost said they embarrassed all of us, but no, they didn't. They embarrassed themselves as an organization to invite the former president, Donald Trump, to an event. He respected them enough to show up and to have these, no, I can't say these, it was just one, this journalist, and let me name them. Let me take a look here. This is Rachel Scott of ABC News. A wretched woman she was. So abhorrent and unwelcoming. So inhospitable. Harris Faulkner of Fox News, we know Harris. We know Harris is not going to come at Donald Trump hard. She's a friend to the former president. And this woman I had not heard of, Khadija Gobba, who was fair in her approach to the president, asked some pressing questions. I appreciated her and her approach. She was not disrespectful, but she did ask some serious questions. We appreciate that. President Trump knew what he was getting into to show up at the Blackity Black event, to talk to the black journalists. He knew that he was going into a hostile environment, and it did not fall short because this ABC News host let him have it from the very beginning to where he had to rebuke her. I know he didn't want to do it, but she forced his hand. And any man being faced with a woman coming at him like that would have responded in the exact same way. But there came a time in the event where a question was asked about black jobs. Let's take a look at what the president had to say, because I know he was reserved in his response. But I also know that we have these kind of questions in the community all the time. We have these discussions, question and answer, and we talk about this. I know Donald Trump is uncomfortable with it because I could tell by his response, but we know what the answer is to the question, what is a black job? Y'all, let's check this out.
Coming from the border are millions and millions of people that happen to be taking black jobs. You had the best.
What exactly is a black job, sir?
A black job is anybody that has a job. That's what it is. Anybody that has a job.
All right.
And
Mr.
they're taking,
President,
they're taking the employment away from black people. They're coming in and they're coming in. They're invading. It's an invasion of millions of people, probably 15, 16, 17 million people. I have a feeling it's much more than that. And everybody's been seeing what's happened. The first group of people, the black population, is affected most by that. And Kamala is allowing it to happen. She's the border czar. She's the worst border czar in the history of the world. There's never been a border czar like this. She's never even essentially been. She said she was there once, but not the right part of the border. So she was a border czar. She's done a horrible job. These people are coming into our country, and they're taking black jobs and Hispanic jobs. And frankly, they're taking union jobs. Unions are being very badly affected by all of the millions of people that are pouring into our country. And one thing, as we discussed, many of these people are coming in from mental institutions, from prisons, from jails. They're gang members in other countries. Other countries are setting loose their prisoners. They're opening up their prisons and their mental institutions, and they're taking their bad people, drug dealers, gang members, and they're bringing them into the United States.
All
and
right.
By the way, their crime rate is going down, and our crime rate is going to be a disaster.
Mr. President.
So there you have it, y'all. The NABJ convention 2024. Donald Trump showed up. Kamala Harris did not. Donald Trump took the hard questions, and he gave it just as well as he got it. He faced these black women. Y'all need to understand this. Look, everybody ain't scared of y'all. Understand that. We get these little degrees and things, and we get to feeling ourselves. We get a little pompous in our approach to life. We think we everything. We are it. But there's always someone who can blow on your situation. It's nice to be nice, y'all. It takes so much more energy to be mean. Takes so much more energy to be disrespectful. And that's what Donald Trump faced at the cookout. So let's address the question. And I could give you all kinds of numbers. I can give you all kinds of statistics, but that's boring and it would make for bad content. So let's just get to the crux of the matter. What is a black job? Well, a black job is any job that black folks en masse are qualified for. Now, this is my definition. You can't find it nowhere else. But if you were having a job fair and you said, I got some jobs that I'm trying to give out, and masses of black folks showed up and they were qualified for those positions, well, those black jobs. Is a doctor a black job? No, it is not. Because there's such a small minority of black doctors in the profession. Could black folks be doctors more often in higher numbers? Yes, they could, but they choose not to be. For a path that is already set, all you gotta do is go to college, take the classes, go to med school, take the classes, pass the exam, you're good. We choose not to go that route. In mass. How about a lawyer? Is a lawyer a black job? No. When I was in law school, they told us that the profession consisted of about 3% African-American practicing attorneys. And of that 3%, most of them are women. And I can attest to that because there was only a handful of black males in my class. It was disheartening to see. But these are the facts. You think being a lawyer is a black job? Take your black lawyer self into a law firm, a white shoe firm. And you're going to find out real quick by the way they look at you, the way they treat you. They don't expect you to be there. No, maybe this ain't a blackity black job. Because y'all so few in number in this profession. Could black folks become lawyers in higher numbers? Absolutely they could. Go to college, go to law school, pass the bar, boom. You're there. The path is already set. Do we do it in mass? No. It's a choice. Could black folks be laborers on a construction site? Absolutely. Pick up these rocks, take them over there. Pick up these 2x4s, take them over there. Carry this rebar way across there. You could do that. Because it just takes physicality and muscles. Could black folks be a maid? Absolutely. In mass? Absolutely. Because grandma taught us how to clean. Grandma taught us how to make a bed. Because she used to work for them folks. She had to do it right. She knew how to do it. She taught us how. She taught us how to fold clothes. She taught us how to tuck sheets. Could we do it? Yes, we could. Now I'm speaking for my generation. Those who came after me, I'm not so sure. Kind of concerned. I'm worried about your skill set as a whole. What could you do in mass? Could you scoop fries? In California, they pay you $20 an hour to scoop fries. I think with proper training, black folks could scoop fries in mass, could make your Big Mac. In mass, to get your fast food order wrong in mass. Could we be delivery drivers and Uber drivers? Well, yeah, black folks drive all the time. Your license might be suspended, but you still drive. We could do that in mass. It's gonna take a little effort because you got to get that license cleaned up. You got to get them tickets paid. Got to take care of them warrants. But once you get over those small hurdles, you could be a driver in mass. I know it hurts to hear the truth. These low-level jobs. Donald Trump don't want to say it because it sounds demeaning coming from him. It sounds demeaning coming from me, but it's the truth, and we need to have this conversation, y'all. If we want to have better, if we want to be better, what do we got to do better? Because the only thing we're qualified for in mass is low-level jobs. We only go to college at a rate of around 30%. Most Black folks don't go to college. So when they get to talking about, Joe Biden get to talking about student loan forgiveness and all that, he ain't talking about us. Because y'all know how we do, right? Somebody go down to the community college, get a student loan in the first semester, you take the loan money and you never go back to class. Am I lying? These are the hard truths. What is a Black job? The job that Black folks are qualified for in mass. I wish we had more engineers. I wish we had more lawyers. I wish we had more doctors. I wish we had more astronauts. I wish we had more entrepreneurs. I wish we had more venture capitalists. But we choose not to go that route in mass. Yeah, we're represented in every field, but only represented in small numbers in certain fields, the most desirable fields, because we choose in mass to turn our cheek away from those opportunities. And it's unfortunate. And if we're going to do better, if we're going to be better, it starts with the children. Don't just get your degree and run away. Take that learning you got and share it with a child. Inspire a child to be like you. Each one, teach one. You got your degree? Share the information. Tell a child how to get that degree, how you made it there. We got so many people who achieve in the community. And then they side with the leftists and tell us that America hates us and we can't achieve. Well, you achieved. Why don't you share your secrets? Why don't you tell us how you did it? Why don't you help out the masses? So we can turn some of these less frequented jobs into Black jobs. So that you ain't so butthurt when some white man, orange man comes and tells you what a Black job is. Oh, you want to get indignant because somebody said Black job. How about you get indignant about the fact that you haven't achieved? How about you get indignant about the fact that you haven't tried hard enough? How about you get indignant about the fact that you haven't given life your all? I know you got to look in the mirror. You got to face some hard truths. You got to come to the realization that you did not live up to your full potential. You could have done more. You could have worked harder. You could have tried. You could have got outside of your comfort zone and done the work. But you capitulated to fear. You'd rather be high, you'd rather be drunk than to put forth the effort. See, you got it bass ackwards. You wanted to play hard before you worked hard, instead of working hard in order to play hard. Boy, I could have this conversation all day. Because I feel like I've had it thousands of times in my life. If we're not going to take responsibility for who we are and what we are, we're not going to take responsibility for the fact that Black jobs are low-level jobs. We can't accept that. Then we'll never do better. And the truth of the matter is, I wish better for the community. And I think Donald Trump wishes better for the Black community as well. That's why he showed up at the Black event knowing that he would face some verbal abuse. I'm sure he didn't expect it the way he got it. But he knew it was a hostile environment and he still showed up out of respect. Y'all, don't let the man you call the orange man, the man you call the racist, the man that came to your event and honored you in your own house, don't let that man have more respect for you than you have for yourself. Let's commit to do better and be better. You know how we do that? I know some of y'all feel like I'm old and I'm burnt out and I can't do it no more. That's fine. It ain't fine, but I understand it. But if that's how you feel, then just pay it forward. Find a youngin', find a child, and be helpful. Help a child along. Help them be better than you were, than you are. You want to change the narrative? You want Black jobs to be better jobs? Then be better people. And I'll leave it there. Y'all, let me know what you think about this. I'd love to know your thoughts on this topic. Drop a comment and let me know. And don't forget to like the video. Subscribe to the channel and share the video so we can get more people involved in the conversation, y'all. And like I always say, always remember and never forget. Without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time. Peace.